At the time, I did feel like there was quite a bit of luck involved, but I think we had many essential ingredients for making such a discovery. So initially we were aiming for quantum spin liquids, and these materials are very hard to create and very hard to probe. The sulfur atoms are being shot at the surface, tantalum atoms are being shot at the surface, and essentially from this point of view it's a random process, and you can end up with having two sheets of this material instead of one sheet. They can combine together to form a heterostructure. I think just out of curiosity I decided to look at one of those, and what I saw surprised me. There was this spectral gap that we did not expect to be there. We were discussing this quite a lot with my colleagues and with our collaborators, what could be the origin of it. There were many ideas coming in, like it could be this, it could be that, and then there were many refutations, like no, it cannot be because of this, it cannot be because of that. The reaction to the first time heavy fermion physics was proposed as the explanation for this idea was a surprise. When our theory collaborator Jose proposed this, it surprised many of us, first of all, because he said it was the simplest explanation, and we thought, okay, heavy fermion physics is something really not simple, it's very complicated. And then also we didn't know that much about it. So I think everyone just jumped really into heavy fermion literature and was like, okay, let me just find out as much as I can about it. And then we knew what is the response in the case that heavy fermion physics is present in the heterostructure, and we were looking for this. And we in fact found exactly what we were looking for. I think we had many essential things that were required for us to get such an achievement. The atmosphere in our research group, the collaborations that we had, also the freedom that people have in our group for pursuing their own goals, and overall curiosity of everyone, I think.